Hi everyone, I'm Ian Kirk, product manager for Instron's low force universal testing machines. Today I'm here with one of our 6800 series systems to discuss Specimen Protect. We'll look at what it does, how you use it, and how it can help reduce variability in your test results. So, what is Specimen Protect? It's a feature on all of our 6800 series systems and retrofits that allows an operator to remove unwanted tensile or compressive forces on a specimen prior to beginning a test. This is important because those unwanted forces can affect your test results. Now let's walk through how we use it. For this example, we're going to run a tensile test on some rigid plastic specimens. When I load this specimen into our pneumatic grips, you'll notice that as soon as I close the jaw faces, we're seeing a compressive load of around 300 newtons. With a 6800 system equipped with a smart close air kit, you'll find that this value is smaller when using a lower initial gripping pressure. Now, when I press the Specimen Protect button on the handset, this load is automatically removed through the motion of the crosshead. We can set the Specimen Protect load threshold in Blue Hill Universal by clicking on the system icon and navigating to the frame menu. From here, you can set your load threshold as well as the responsiveness. The responsiveness defines the speed at which the frame will adjust to reach the load threshold. Typically, we'll want to use a low responsiveness for fragile or extremely stiff materials, such as composites or glass, to prevent the specimen from fracturing prior to starting the test. Going back to loading the specimen, I do want to mention that in order to properly apply Specimen Protect, you'll want to enable it prior to loading a specimen. Blue Hill can be configured to automatically enable Specimen Protect at the end of each test, simplifying your workflow and adding consistency between operators. It's also best practice to use Specimen Protect in conjunction with a preload to ensure consistent results. Now that we've run 10 specimens, let's take a look at our results graph to see the effect Specimen Protect has had on our data. Both maximum load and maximum displacement had lower variability and higher averages for the specimens tested when Specimen Protect was enabled. Looking more closely at the graph, you can see the distribution of the curves at the region of failure, which really highlights the difference in variability. I want to add a quick reminder. There are times you wouldn't want to have Specimen Protect enabled. For example, if Specimen Protect is enabled while changing out a grip or fixture, the crosshead will begin to move slowly as the system attempts to remove the load from the load cell. However, in this instance, Specimen Protect will automatically disable itself and stop the crosshead movement if the load doesn't decrease within a couple seconds. And that's a quick look at Specimen Protect. For more information about 6800 series features, please check out some of our other YouTube videos, visit Instron.com, or reach out with any questions. Thanks for watching.